All right, folks, and welcome back to season number two. It's part two of what will probably be three-parter of the home nations in the Premier League. I say Premier League. Of course, if you've watched episode one, you know that the Republic of Ireland were, in fact, relegated to the Championship. So, home nations into the Premier League, but actually also now we need to focus a little bit on the Championship. But before we do that, I think it's worthwhile taking a look at the World Cup. In Russia, of course, the World Cup 2018, the FIFA World Cup there, you can see, oh, there's Mexico, but England beaten in the final, not on penalties as you might have expected, beaten in the final. So whether or not they would have done that anyway is up for debate. You can see that England took an early lead, Harry Kane, but then an Araujo before an equaliser just in stoppage time in that first half, before Jonathan Dos Santos' goal sealed the win, and quite justifiably so. It looks as though Mexico certainly bossed that game. But yeah, whether or not England would have done that anyway, you can see there are a few more players that aren't in our England team, like Troy Deeney's in there. We've also got Theo Walcott. Aaron Cresswell was perhaps unlucky not to make the England club. So whether or not they would have made it anyway is up for debate. But that's how they did. In terms of the league this season, then, one thing that we didn't touch on last time was managers. So we will look to see who kept their jobs from the start of the experiment right through to the end of this current season. And the managers that were appointed to the sides were the actual current managers, apart from Wales, who adopted Mr. Tony Pulis. And that's a nod to the former Stoke manager himself. Otherwise, Malky Mackay was kept in charge of the Scotland squad, and we kept with Michael O'Neill in charge of Northern Ireland. I know that that's a little bit iffy at the moment. It might stay that way, it might not. But I thought it may as well best to leave him in charge of the club side. So it'd be interesting to see if maybe they stuck with him. So let's have a look at that Premier League then, the 2018-19, and see who finished where. Okay, so there's your league table. England finished third. Champions League football on its way to England, and Scotland in seventh. Europa League football for Scotland. A 10th place finish for Wales. They'll be okay with that. But Scotland, quite a surprising jump. You remember last time they finished 17th, and you were thinking maybe they were a team to go down. But they've managed to qualify for Europe. 20 wins. That's pretty good. England securing themselves a berth in that top four in Champions League football. Not that they need the revenue, but it's going to be good for them. Northern Ireland, though, we did say maybe for a good favourite to be relegated, and relegated they have been, finishing 18th with just 28 points, relegated down back to the Championship. I say back to the Championship, or relegated down to the Championship with Wolves and Sunderland. So let's just have a look at top performers, at least, before we pop in and have a look at how Ireland got on in the Championship. So you can see England did pretty well. Harry Kane, of course, 28 goals. You can see he's got 39 goals in 76 for England as a club side. He's also got 20 in 43 caps for England as well. So pretty good goals. And also 20 from Dele Alli. Those two have thrived for England Football Club. You can see he's got 21 in 73. Not quite as good as his ratio for Tottenham, but still pretty elite attacking midfielder. Ooh, he's an elite. Other than that, goals also across the pitch from Jamie Vardy, Marcus Rashford's return on loan, he had a spell at Napoli. Raheem Sterling with 17 goals. That's pretty good for him. You can see there's goals all throughout the midfield, and the defenders adding in with a couple, Harry Maguire, etc. Harry Maguire, interestingly, is the defender of choice, partnering John Stones. It's not Phil Jones, it's not Chris Smalling or Michael Keane. He's actually the weakest of along with Smalling. Those are the two weakest. And the goalkeeping slot is pretty much half and half between Hart and Butland. Hart could be what you call them. Hart proving to be the better choice. So England doing okay, as you might expect, with the quality of player at their disposal. Scotland, though, very impressive 7th place finish. They must have done pretty well. You can see there, Lee Griffiths with 14 goals in this Premier League campaign. And again, goals from midfield. It really is. There's no double figures like we've got with England. But Chris Martin as well up front, popping up with 8 goals. That's pretty much 1 in 2 for him. And then midfield, you've got goals throughout the park from Naismith, Armstrong and Ritchie. Snodgrass with a few. and also Matt Phillips, of course. So they've been doing pretty well. I think they've had a marked improvement, perhaps defensively. Andy Robertson there, 7.29 rating out of the 36 games. That's pretty good. We forgot to have a look at the England's Europa League campaign. We'll do that in a moment. But first, we need to pop in and see how Wales got on. You can see last season they finished 8th, so they've had a little bit of a drop-off in that respect, although not too much. 8th to 10th in the Premier League is probably much and muchness. But here are their performances, and you can see that it's Gareth Bale with 6.74. Oh my, he's unhappy. He wants to leave for continental football. Whether Wales or not will give him that. I mean, he can't leave because... Well, I mean, they can leave. I don't know what I'm saying. He can leave, but why would Wales sell him? Unless he's that miserable that he's affecting the old dynamics. But Ben Woodburn, he is starting to provide the goals. 16 for him, so he's coming good. Less goals for Sam Vokes, only 9. But again, goals in midfield through Aaron Ramsey. And a few as well for David Brooks. He's coming along quite nicely. So some decent performances. A nice 7.42 from Ben Davies as well. It'll be interesting to see if anybody wants him. He is wanted by Chelsea. A few of these players will be wanted. I mean, you've got... James Chester is on his way out to Spartak Moscow. Of course he is. Why wouldn't he be? Let's have a look at the Northern Irish side. Relegated this term. Ignore those kits. I couldn't get rid of them. So this is the Northern Ireland team. Goals are always going to be a problem. Top scorer was actually Chris Brunt with 5. So their strikers only managing a total of 8 goals between them, really. They had Kyle Lafferty return, and he managed to score 4 in 7. Not too bad, but these average ratings are an absolute disaster. 6.77, the absolute best of them from Stuart Maguire, and he's a regen, a 16-year-old regen, so he can't really be trusted. In fact, did he play a Premier League game? No, he did not, so you can ignore that 6.77. 6.5, well, out of regular performers, you've got to say the 6.48 from Niall McGinn, he's not even a striker. So you're looking at a 6.38 from Connor Washington. That's the elite performances that the Northern Irish are putting in. Johnny Evans, though, credible, 7.17 in a relegated side. You've got to assume that he'd be transferred out. And Stephen Davis as well, 7.25 from his 39 games. So those are the two standout players for the Northern Irish side. It was not enough. They've been relegated to the Championship. That's where Ireland went last year, the Republic of Ireland. Will they have managed to get out of the Championship? Well, you can see there they beat my beloved Stoke in the playoffs on a penalty shootout, no less, after a 1-1 draw. Ross Barkley plays for Stoke. Of course he does. I mean, of course, a lot of these players were sold, it looks as though, by England and his contracts. England didn't give Ross Barkley a new contract. I did only give them small deals, but all clubs had a lot of money to spend. But yeah, Stoke snapped up Ross Barkley, and he's playing in the Championship, so that's what that was. Let's see then, they must have finished in the top 6, obviously. I don't know what I'm doing, it's slipped the league table, there we go. So yeah, they finished on 84 points and are promoted straight back to the Premier League, so they bounced back at the first time of asking. Be interested to see if they survive in the next season. Obviously they were quite weak when they went down, and you've got to assume that they've probably sold a few players out when they got relegated. Indeed, they did. They bought in $63 million. You've got Jeff Hendrick going out, Robbie Brady, Richard Keogh, Kieran Clarke, James McCarthy, Harry Arter, and Alex Pearce. Interestingly as well, you see Harry Arter moving out to Leipzig. Okay then. So yeah, let's take a look at England's campaign in the old Europa League. That's where they finished last year. Okay, there you go. So you can see England were placed into a group containing Bilbao, Alkmaar and Rijeka. They absolutely crushed their way through the group, winning all 6 games, 18 points. So excellent for them. The eagle-eyed, I can't hide it. England won. Holders England. So we will see how they got there. The first knockout round, England beat on aggregate 4-1 Dynamo Kiev. So cruising through, it looks as though they're going to cruise through every round. Ooh, a tight one. 2-1 home winners? 2-1 aggregate winners over Lazio. Quite a tie that would have been. A quarter final. 3-1 over Bilbao. So they met Bilbao in the group stage. Then they crushed Galatasaray by 5-1 before a final against Napoli, winning 3-0. And Harry Kane and Dele Alli, of course. It seems as though those two together in this kind of team are absolutely dynamite. So hopefully, England fans, I'm one of you. Hopefully, we can do the business in Russia with those two. But I have my doubts. So that's England in the Europa League. Europa League winners. They're going to the Champions League this time round because they finished third and, of course, they've won the Europa League. Be interesting to see next season how Scotland do. Ooh. Let's just pop back to England and see if we had anyone transferred out who did. England sold £31.5 million as a player. Jordan Pickford, Jake Livermore, Tammy Abraham going out on loan to Stoke, and Danny Welbeck going to Liverpool. If Danny Sturridge wasn't enough as an injured striker for Liverpool, Danny Welbeck now certainly will be. Let's take a look at Scotland, see if they sold anyone out. They did indeed, but far less, £2.8 million. They sold Stephen Fletcher to Akhmat. I don't know who they are. They're a Grozny, of course. Grozny in the Russian Premier League, £2.1 to £2.9 million. A few players out on loan, and then Jordan Archer, Christoph Berra. Those loan players will be academy graduates. So a few players out for the Scots. Did Wales sell anyone? They did. They sold Robson Kanu to Atlas, and Ashley Williams has gone out to Levante. Tom Bradshaw out to Bolton on loan. And the last one to check would be Northern Ireland. They only released a youth academy graduate, David McDonnell to Bradford. So nothing doing there. So they cannot blame transfers for their relegation, sadly. As I say, ignore the Watford kits there. They replace Watford, and for some reason I cannot get rid of the Watford kits in the code. So they're stuck with them for the duration of the experiment. And speaking of the experiment, that'll draw this video to a close. If there is anything you'd like to see, as I said in the last video, anything specific, teams, clubs, players, that kind of thing, where, you know, as I said, Watford, Newcastle, Brighton, Huddersfield and Burnley, all those players were released. So there are players who haven't got clubs who will have had to have been acquired by other teams. So if you're interested in where maybe some of them ended up, if they've just had their clubs terminated, which is obviously likely, do let me know and we'll have a look together on the final video, which is coming up on Thursday. So yeah, do pop a comment on if you've got any interests. And leave a like on the video and subscribe for far more. I'll see you again on the next video. Goodbye.